Akura dayaro sagoro idase koruna kori o he Vaishnava Thakura he Vaishnava Thakura dayaro sagoro idase koruna kori o he Vaishnava Kabo diya podo chaya shodho he amari tomar charano dhari diya podo chaya পদ ছায়া শোধ হে আমায় তোমার চরণ ধরি দিয়া পদ ছায়া ওহে বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর দয়ার সাগর এদাসে করুণা করি ওহে বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর ছয় বেগ দমি ছয় দোষ সধি ছয় গুণ দেহ দাসে ছয় বেগ দমি ছয় বেগ দমি ছয় দোষ সধি ছয় গুণ দেহ দাসে ছয় বেগ ছয় সাত সঙ্গ দেহ হে আমারে ছয় সাত সঙ্গ দেহ হে আমি বসেছি সঙ্গে রয়াসে বসেছি সঙ্গে রে বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর দয়ার সাগর এদাসে করুণা করি ওহে বৈষ্ণব একাকী আমার নাহি পায়ে বল হরি নাম সংকীর্তনে একাকী আমার একাকী আমার নাহি পায়ে বল হরি নাম সংকীর্তনে কাকি আমার বৈষ্ণব তুমি কৃপা করি শ্রদ্ধা বিন্দু দিয়া তুমি কৃপা করি শ্রদ্ধা বিন্দু দেহ কৃষ্ণ নাম ধনে দেহ কৃষ্ণ নাম ওহে বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর দয়ার সাগর এদাসে করুণা করি ওহে বৈষ্ণব কৃষ্ণ সে তোমার কৃষ্ণ দিতে পার তোমার সকতি আছে কৃষ্ণ সে তোমার কৃষ্ণ সে তোমার কৃষ্ণ দিতে পার তোমার সকতি আছে কৃষ্ণ সে তোমার প্রভু আমি তো কাঙ্গাল কৃষ্ণ কৃষ্ণ বলি আমি তো কাঙ্গাল Krishna Krishna Hai ami to kangal Krishna Krishna boli ami to kangal Krishna Krishna Bhai tobo pache pache Bhai tobo pache Ohe Vaishnava Thakura Dayara Sagara Edase Karuna Kori Ohe Vaishnava Ohe Vaishnava Thakura Dayara Sagara Edase Karuna Kori Ohe Vaishnava Krishna Deva Bhavantam Bande Yadapi Samadhi Subhidhirapi Pashati Natabana Khagramariti Yadapi Samadhi Subhidhirapi Pashati Natabana Khagramariti Idami chami nishamata vachuta tadapi kripad bhuta vichim Idami chami nishamata vachuta Krishna deva bhavantam vande Krishna Mana mana samadhu kara mara payani japada pankaja makarande mana mana sam Krishna deva bhavantam vande Krishna Bhaktirudanchate jadapi madhava natai mama tilamati O parameshwarata tadapi tavadika durghata ghatana vidhati Deva Bhavantam Vande Krishna Oh Mana Mana Samadhukara Marpaya Nija Pada Pankaja Makarande Mana Krishna Deva Bhavantam Vande Ayama bilolata yadashanatana kalitade bhutara sabharam Ayama bilolata yadashanatana kalitade bhutara sabharam Anivasato etamrihamrita ninnene vindana madhuri masharam Anivasato Vendana Madhuri Mahe Krishna Deva Bhavantam Vande Krishna Oh Mana Mana Samadhukara Marpaya Nija Pada Pankaja Makarande Mana Bhavantam Vande Hare Krishna Deva Bhavantam Vande Vande Jai 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 Radha Ramana Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol. Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol. Radha Ramana Hari Bol. Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol. Radha Ramana Hari Hari Bol, 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 Radha Ramana Hari Bol, Jai Radhe. Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Mukunda Madhav Govinda Bol, Mukunda Jana Ballava Jaya Giri.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरत्विषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमः तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं न माम चरणान्तिके Today I think it's a very fortunate day for us all. We have come from India, especially from Vrindavan, to preach the same thing which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which Krishna and Radhika himself are all our disciplined guru, came to this world to preach the same mission. In this world, I think all wants to be happy. Anyone of this world don't want to be unhappy. And that happiness also should be unmixed with any sorrow, sufferings. We like it. This is called ananda. We like ananda. You know ananda word? Ananda means happiness. But this ananda cannot come without prem, love and affection. So, happiness and love is same thing. Pure happiness of life, pure love and affection we want. But we see that in this world, sometimes very little happiness or affection comes, but comes with, mixed with sorrow and sufferings. We don't want to be old. We don't want that our hair should be white. We don't want that we should see less or we should become blind. We want that we should be always young and young. So beautiful. But after some time, you will be old, possibly, whether you want or not. Oldness will come and marry us very fast. We want to marry, but not to any old lady, or she is not so beautiful. Ugly. But oldness is ugly. And anyone will not like to marry her. But forcibly she marries. You want or not. Your teeth will go away. Whether you are taking nakli dant. Nakali? Nahi janta hai nakali ka? Not real, unreal.
False teeth.
False. That teeth. We can take some medicine to make our hairs, grey hairs or white hairs black. Also, very beautiful cheeks will have so many, like old persons.
Wrinkles.
So, we'll have to be old and marry oldness. And one day, we cannot walk. So many persons will come and help me to go to last stage, to where grapes are burning.
Crematorium.
So many persons will come. In India, thousands of persons taking that dead body go to funeral place. Bad place. And they burn it. If you will not burn, if you will burn it, it will be ashes. If you will not burn, Then so many wild dogs, jackals, hawks and all will come. And they will quarrel for that. This is mine, this is mine. Why you came? And it will be like vista. It's like a stool. And if they will not touch, then so many worms and insects will, this body will become. In the last stage, it will bound to be like so. So we should think from where the soul has come. Whether we are soul or this body. It is the fundamental truth that this body is not soul. There is so much difference between our soul and this body. And knowing this, we'll have to be detached somewhat from worldly luxuriousness. And after that, we'll have to know we are the part and parcel of Godhead, Supreme Personality of Godhead. We are not a... We have come here as a refugee here. You know refugee?
Refugee.
Not our own land. So this world is as a place of refugees. We'll have to give up this world one day. Whether you want or not want, he will vacate you in a moment. So where to go? If you have no affection for Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has created this world, who is brought up and supporting this world, and after this world is old, then goes into him, he is God. What is the meaning of God? G, generator. O, operator, who operates whole world. Without his, sun cannot shine, earth cannot stand, world will be of nowhere. So he is operating. And D, destroyer also. He is God. He is Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. Know this meaning? I think that Tamil persons can know. Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. He did not die, he did not take birth. He is eternal. God is one. God is not so many one. In Vedas it had been written, in Vedas and all scriptures in India, that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. He has so many names. He has so much power, infinite power. He is so beautiful. Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. Anyone like beautiful thing. But if a beautiful man, person or thing has some poison in it, we cannot love. We cannot want. No. So it must be Satyam, Shivam. Shivam means Kalyanakari.
Auspiciousness.
He should be merciful. He should be almighty and so much beautiful. Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. There is none beautiful like Krishna. A boy very beautiful, three-folding, playing on flute, smiling somewhat, fragrance coming from his body, he attracts everyone. Whether cows, whether anyone in this world, he attracts everyone. So Krishna is so much beautiful, he is so much merciful, and he is sab samay ke liye nitya hai, eternal. Everything in Krishna. He can fulfill all kinds of wishes. We know Nishing Bhagavan, he is God. He is powerful, but he is not beautiful like Krishna. You know, he has his head like a lion and very dangerous. Rama is so beautiful, but he cannot fulfill all the things. Jesus Christ is powerful, but he will only like father and mother, not like husband, not like a shakha. Shakha means friend. Nrisimha Bhagavan cannot be like a friend because he is so dangerous, but he protects all, but not so much beautiful like Krishna. So Krishna is unparalleled beautiful, unparalleled, but Shivam, merciful, having all the good qualities, and so beautiful, and omnipotent. You should take my mood, because my English is not so good. Very, very poor. I don't know how I'm speaking. So, Krishna can fulfill all the wishes we have. Anyone cannot do like this. So, if you have a little affection for him, honor for him, he can fulfill all our things. So he is our supreme personality of Godhead. Even what Ramchandra cannot give, Krishna can give everything. So if we have some affection and love for Krishna, then we may be so happy for all times, also for coming times also. Here also, and next birth also, and after birth, if we have salvation, liberation, then also. So we should try to have affection with Krishna, with God. Yes, he is embodiment of love and affection. And the way the gopis of Prabhu love him is the best way. For this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world. He is himself Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But for mercifully, because he is causeless. He is causeless merciful. He loves all us, of all us, because we are part and parcel of him. So he came to give these things. You cannot be happy if you are not coming towards Krishna. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world to give these things. He tried to detach us from the worldly affairs, worldly enjoyments, worldly false egos and false happiness, and to give that kind of eternal bliss and eternal love and affection, so that you can easily be happy and you can be peaceful, otherwise not. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, at that time he took sannyas order.
Renounce order.
You know renounce order? Give up his wife, children, everything. And he took sannyas and left everything, his mother, old mother. His wife, very newly married, Vishnu Priya Devi, all weeping there and lamenting. He went to Jagannath Puri and he went to South India up till Kanyakumari. He moved everywhere and gave all these things to persons. And he made all bhakta, bhakta means
devotee.
Then he returned to Puri and he wanted to go to Vrindavan. You know Vrindavan? You have been. Very decent place, very beautiful, Krishna as Krishna. Flowing Jamuna so sweetly, all kinds of best flowers, Beli, Chameli, Yui, lotus fields, flowers and all. Very calm and quiet, cool breeze always blowing, going on. He wanted to go and to meet Krishna as a mood of Radhika. He was coming to Vrindavan on the path of Ganges and Jamuna, because Jamuna comes from Vrindavan to Prayag and it meets to Ganges, and from Ganges now coming to Navadvip, Calcutta, and at last in Bay of Bengal. So there was only path to go to Vrindavan by the side of Ganges. So he was coming. But it was mere bahana tha.
Excused.
It was only a trick.
Yes.
No? He wanted to meet Rupa and Sanatan, very learned persons, young personality, so qualified person. They lived at the bank of Ganges and they were prime minister and private secretary of the king, Mohammedan king Hussein Shah. They met with Rupa and Sanatan and told, don't waste your time. I'm going to Vrindavan. I'm now returning to Jagannath, but after some time I will go to Vrindavan. You should come to Vrindavan. And I want to be with you, hearing Hari Katha, Krishna Katha. How he was in Vrindavan? What pastimes he played? What is written in Srimad Bhagavatam and Gita? We will discuss all these things. They were ready, gradually they become detached from the kingdom and all these things. And at last Rupa Goswami first went to Vrindavan. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not present there, so he was returning. He gave up his all kinds of worldly things, all property, all money, everything. Then why he gave up? You know that if Krishna has given birth, He has given everything for us. And if sorrow is coming without wanting, unhappiness is coming without wanting, then everything will come also. Money will come, praise will come, everything will come. So we don't want to waste our time, Rupa and Sanatana thought, and Rupa Goswami went to Vrindavan. But he was returning back because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not there. In the meantime, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Benaras, Prayag, and they met together there. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to this world, Krishna has come to this world, taking the mood and beauty of Srimati Radhika to give something, positive thing, love and affection to all kinds of persons. Even to animals and trees. And when today we were walking in the field, I wanted to tell the devotee that you should try to chant Hare Krishna more loudly. But I was chanting, I missed. If you go anywhere, you can chant loudly, then trees, creepers, animals, insects, all will hear it. Whether they don't know meaning or no meaning, no harm. If you don't know the meaning of fire, even if you will touch fire, it will burn you. Understand? It is surely fine. So if you are chanting name, whether you know meaning or not, all animals, grasses and everything will hear, and they will, in their another birth, they will have associations of pure bhakti. And thus gradually they will develop their Krishna consciousness, and they will be liberated from this world. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave everything what is positive, like what is bhakti. What is bhakti rasa? Rasa means so everything. And he inspired everything in his heart what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give the world, but he could not give. He inspired also Sanatana Goswami, Vaidhi Bhakti. You know Vaidhi Bhakti? That rules and regulations of bhaktis. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu especially gave devotion, bhakti, rasa, devotion and love. How it can be increased to God? How can we develop all these things? How a minus will come? Minus means?
Possessiveness.
Possessiveness to Krishna. Krishna is mine. God is mine. I am His. So this will come. Then he, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, came to Vrindavan. No. He was coming from Vrindavan. And he told Rupa Goswami that you should go to Vrindavan and write books. Then he wrote so many books, Bhakti, Rasamrita, Sindhu. What is bhakti? We have no pure conceptions of bhakti. What is bhakti? Swarup Goswami, in his book, in four parts, he wrote so many things about bhakti. What is bhakti? So if you will not know all these things, only we will distribute books, we will not taste in what is in that book, only distribution will not do. Only making temples will not do. We should try to make our heart temple where Krishna and Radhika should be there. This is positive thing. Only negative thing will not do. You know, vairagya?
Renounce.
Detachment. Only detachment will not do if there is not any positive thing. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Rupa Goswami has tried. Srila Raghunath Goswami has all tried to give the positive thing. This is the main thing. If we don't know what is that positive, prem or love or affection, and we have no affection for Krishna, in chanting, in remembering the pastimes of Krishna, also remembering the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how he was so merciful to Jagai and Madhai also. And in that time Jagai and Madhai were only two. But in these days, very pure devotion, devotee are two only, and all others are Jagai and Madhai. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave this positive thing. We should try to take these positive things. Without positive thing, only detachment and negative things will not do. Even the four things, you know, tinadapi suni chena, tarurapi sahishnuna, amanina, manadena, kirtaniya sadahari. You know the meaning? You should explain the meaning of this shloka.
One should consider himself like lower than a blade of grass. Nadapi sudichena. Tororapi sudishuna. Tororiva sudishuna. One should be more tolerant than...
More loudly.
One should be more tolerant than a tree. And amanina manadena. One should not desire any kind of respect for himself, but he should give respect to all. Girtaniya sadhavani. In this condition of mind, then one can always perform Harikirtan.
But if anyone has three qualities, then all qualities, all qualities. But in positiveness, there is no love and affection for Krishna. He is not chanting, not remembering. Then what is the use of these four? Nothing, zero, cipher. Understand what I am going to tell? If all the qualities are there, but we have no Krishna bhakti, no affection for Krishna, we have no interest in chanting, remembering, then no use of all these things. Then we are like Mayavadi. Mayavadi, you know?
Monism.
So, if these four are not there, but Guru has given Hari name and he has given Diksha, initiation, and he is chanting, remembering something, but not possesses these four qualities in full, but by association these will come gradually. But if we have no trust for Krishna, we are not chanting Krishna, remembering Krishna. If four qualities are, all qualities, likes and likes qualities are there, but even like cipher. If one is in left side and zero is in right side, then it is 10. No? And if one is there and after that two zeros are given, three is given, four, five, six, then it will come to like, more than lakhs and so on. But if you will take off one and lakhs, 100 zeros, what is the
value of
the lakhs, zeros? Nothing. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come and his all followers there have come to give this positive thing, how he can possess this? So he wrote first sloka in Bhaktirasamrita Sindhu. What a sloka he wrote? Anna bhilashita sunyam jnan karma dhanabritam anukullena krishnan silanam bhakti ruttama. You should try to remember this sloka. Very valuable sloka. Not even written in Srimad Bhagavat, frankly written like this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very, very happy to hear all these things, slokas. So I would like to explain something about this sloka. One kirtan should be done to rest myself. Mahamantra you can do, or any, you know. Adunyam? Can play or he can play? Bombo. Nandanam, namami nandanam. You are not remembering with me? We should try to explain that is sloka of bhakti. Anna bhilasita sunyam jnan karma dhyanabhritam Anukullena Krishna Anushilanam Bhakti Ruttama. Anukullena Krishna Anushilanam Bhakti Ruttama. Bhakti means to serve. To whom serve? The personality,
supreme
personality of Godhead, that is embodiment of prem or prem, love and affection. Everything is so loving attack for Krishna. His eyes are crooked. His desh is so crooked. He gives invitation to all to come to serve Krishna. His speaking is so sweet. His dancing is so sweet. His talking is so sweet. His everything is sweet. His mother is sweet. His sakhis are so sweet. His Vrindavan is sweet. His Jamuna is sweet. His father is sweet. Everything of Krishna is sweet. Especially the mouth is so sweet. Eye is very beautiful. There is not any uske liye udaharan nahi diya ja sakta.
No example.
We cannot give any example of this world. So beautiful, everything.
No comparison.
All comparisons of poets have been felt there. How beautiful, sweet is Krishna. To serve Krishna is also so sweet. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give this sweetness to all persons, all creatures, not only to Hindu, not only Muslims, even to animals, creepers, trees and animals and everyone. At that time a flood came from Navadvip, Mayapur, and it took in his stomach all world.
What?
Inundated the whole world. Flooded all world. All Mayavadi, Karmi, Jnani, Yogi, Tapasri, all were drowned in that flood. And that was prem flow. Love and a flood of affection and love. Mayavadi at once ran away to Puri and to Kashi. But flood went following them, and at last catch up and they drowned in that. It was a very beautiful thing at that time when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. To give this sweetness of Krishna, because he was himself Krishna, and plus Srimati Radhika. So combined mercy of Radha and Krishna was in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is why he gave this prem, which is even Brahma has not that. Shiva has nothing, that prem. And that prem he gave to all the person to whom he looked. They are going, walking in the street at Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and gave prem to them also. So he is telling to Rupa Goswami and he wrote this verse. Anukullena Krishnanushilanam. To serve sweet Krishna by all the organs we have, hands, face, everyone, eyes, tongue, everything. By mind and also by mood. And after that, by soul, we can serve Krishna. So we will have to serve Krishna to please Krishna. But not only to please, Like Charun Mushti, they wanted to Krishna, kill Krishna. But Krishna was so happy to wrestle with them that he wanted to taste this beer rush.
Mellow of fighting.
Mellow of fighting. Mellow of fighting. Sweetness of fighting. He wanted to taste. Krishna became happy, but it is not bhakti. Yashoda was chastising Krishna, folding his hands, folding himself here and there, rebuking, chastising. Krishna was weeping. No mother, I will not do like this. And he was weeping. But yet it is bhakti. Because he wanted to make Krishna so strong, wise, and all things. So we should try to serve Krishna by all the organs we have. If you cannot, by mind you can do. By moods you can do. Krishna is my. Krishna is my priyatam. Priyatam means dear.
Most dearest.
Huh?
Most dearest.
Most dearest. Krishna is my son. Krishna is my friend. We can do it. I'll explain it tomorrow, but I'm giving hint, little hint, that it will not be pure and developed unless we are giving up all the worldly desires. Anna Abhilashita Shunyam. What is Anna Abhilashita Shunyam? We should not desire any worldly things, anything from Krishna by serving. He will please and give up all these things, what we want. I have no child, I want a child. Oh Krishna, give me one child. I am praying you. I am doing bhakti. This is not bhakti. No? If Krishna tells that you should, what you want, you should pray for that. Prahlad Maharaj told, I don't want anything. I am not a businessman. So bhakti is not a thing to be like a business thing. Give and take, give and take. To give ourselves everything in the lotus feet of Krishna. I am giving an example of Anna Abhilashita Shunyam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, newly married Vishnu Priya Devi. Vishnu Priya Devi was so, so lovely and so beautiful. And at that time in whole India, she was beautiful. She was not young, less than young, she was Kishori. Kishori?
Teenage.
Going to be young, less than young, so beautiful, marvelous. Youngness, not so beautiful. Beautiful. But those who are going to be young, but not yet young, the girls, so beautiful. So she was like a Kishori, very beautiful. One Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give up this world and to take renounce order. At very that day, he went to walk in his village. He went to villagers. Among them, there were some also milkmen, Gwala. Gwala, you know, go.
Milkmen.
Milking men. They gave Chaitanya Mahaprabhu milk. He went to Tambuli. Tambuli means those who make betel net. They get betel net. He went to fruitsmen. They get so many fruits. Everywhere where he went, lovely, they get something. Koi, not denotion. Kya? Unko upahar diya.
Present some.
They presented something. He took it all and came to his house. It was now evening. He told his mother that make a very delicious food of
pumpkin and milk.
That
pumpkin.
Pumpkin. Pumpkin, milk and sugar. Giving kapoor, karpinman,
camphor.
Of camphor and so many things. She made it, she cooked it. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu offered to Krishna or Narayana, and he took and he kept something for his mother and wife. In the night, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to his wife. He had never gone to his wife, never met, always doing chanting Hare Krishna, weeping. Sometime falling down on the earth, rolling on the earth, always crying, where Krishna you are, where you are. Always crying. But today he was turned something. Today he went to his wife in decorated form. He was taking battle net also, and with him there was a battle net. He gave from his own hand to Vishnupriya today, and he decorated his hair, gave flowers in his
inner hair.
What?
Braids.
Inner braids.
Like Indian girls, they decorate their face with champak pushpa and other pushpas. He decorates her so much. And trying to speak, smiling something. But by this behavior, Vishnupriya was weeping, not so pleased. She was not happy. Why? Why he has turned today, after so many, 3-4 years, his marriage has been done, but he has not spoke with me. Always trying, weeping, Krishna, Krishna. Why he became so? Today, in the morning I went to take bath in Ganges. In the way, a stone was there and my feet was what?
Injured.
And blood was coming. I was thinking, why it is so? And when I went in Ganges and took bath, my
nose ring during the marriage ceremony,
which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has gave him, it was gone in river. She tried to search it, but not found. She was weeping, oh, my best thing in my life, I have missed. What today will happen, I don't know. She came weeping to her
mother-in-law,
Sachi Devi, and began to weep. She told to, she wanted to
console her.
She asked, why you are weeping so? She told that I have lost my life today. My marriage ring, nose ring, had been lost. I don't know what will be today. So she is thinking here, a lamp is going to be set up, it goes on. What?
यदि एक लैंप
बुझने को होता है तो वो ऊपर में उठता है फिर धप 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 सो ही इज सिंगिंग लाइक दिस टुडे चैतन्य महाप्रभु My husband is loving so much, he is decorating by himself and try to speak, smiling. But he sends something wrong. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It was 12 in night. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ordered his Jogmaya, that gone Vishnupriya, and make her sleep. So sound sleep she cannot know anything. So very sound sleep came by Jogmaya, and she went to sleep. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu only short words her, "Today I am giving up all things. All money, land, old mother, whole family, this new married wife, his pratishtha, pratishtha means
fame,
everything he is giving up." And went to Ganges in the midnight. Mother Sachiva waiting on the door. She became like wood. She cannot move. Tears were dry. Heart was dry. What to do? She cannot think. Could not think. In separation mood, he became like wood, like dead body. She could not check her child, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave three parikrama of Sachima, four, and he did pranam to Chaitanya mother. Mother could not bless him, nor he took embrace, nor told anything. Like dumb he was seeing only. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came out of his home. River Ganges was flowing sweetly. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, "Where Krishna you are, where? Without you, I cannot alive." And he jumped in the sea. "Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama."
He went to Kantak Nagari and took renounce order from
Keshav Bharati.
So this is Anya Abhilash. If you want to serve Krishna and to please Krishna, you will have to be like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Vishnupriya, like Sachi Devi. If you want to fully serve Krishna, where Krishna, where Krishna? This is called Anya Abhilashitasa. Rest we will discuss and explain tomorrow. Gaur Pramanande. Ek Mahamantra karu tab iske baad.
Be prepared for aarti.